Family is everything. Family is priceless. Don't miss the moments, especially the final ones. Pure PLAYRZ Production allows you to be there with our live stream service. It's totally customizable. Song lyrics and readings can be added live. Our website calculates your costs in real time. Visit pureplayersproduction.company.site or pureplaypro.com and be there.
Hello. Good evening, everyone. Are you all hearing? Yes? Yes, okay. Thank you, everyone, for coming out this evening to this, our opening of the exhibition of the works of John Gillespie. We're going to get started. My name is Renata Alam. I'm a registered architect. I'm the honorary treasurer of the TTIA, the curator of the exhibit, and a former employee of Mr. John Gillespie. So just some housekeeping for tonight. We're at the lovely Castle Killarney. There's no eating or drinking inside the building, so that's why we started off here in the beautiful garden. The washrooms are on the smaller building where you entered. I hope everyone is comfortable and has helped themselves, right? So Father Hudlin is going to start off the evening with a blessing of the exhibit. Father Hudlin is currently the parish priest at St. Finbarr's Roman Catholic Church.
We are grateful to God for the gift of creativity, for the grace that God has endowed human beings so that they can in turn enhance human life. We thank the Lord for the gift of grace that has flooded every one of us gathered on this special ground today. We ask the Lord to bless the work of one of his servants, John, and we pray that as he has created these marvelous exhibits, we pray that the Lord would continue to bless all of us who can behold beauty. Bless our time together, O God, and may our eyes always be open to recognize greatness, beauty, and truth. We give you thanks today, for we are privileged to be able to know this great servant of yours. We make our prayer today with thanksgiving in our hearts to the God who has loved us into life forever and ever. Amen.
Right. And now we have a few opening remarks. Hello. Yeah, we have a few opening remarks from the TTIA's president, Akindele Looby.
All right. Good evening, all. Architecture is the starting point for anyone who wants to take humanity towards a better future. A quote from Le Corbusier. Happy World Architecture Day to all of you on behalf of the Trinidad and Tobago Institute of Architects. It's my pleasure to welcome, on behalf of the TTIA, to this opening of the retrospective of the architect John Gillespie. He has accomplished much through his six-decade career in Trinidad and Tobago, his adopted home, having arrived here in 1957. His is a career that started around the time of this country's independence, and John, through his work, would seek to define with others a post-colonial expression of architecture and the built landscape. Through the years, his design palette embraced a regional context, use of available material, passive design responsive to our architecture, economic constraints, and consideration of our local workforce. We can define John's work as authentic architecture, responsive to place, expressive of culture, resources, and the aspirations of this young nation. Trinidad Tobago architect is indeed a part of the very fabric of nation building. As you may imagine, John Gillespie would have mentored, influenced, and inspired many local architects who have passed through his office. And so he leaves a legacy equal or even greater than the over 200 buildings that he has designed. You must know the built environment and architecture impacts your very lives every day. And I encourage all of us to think critically about the spaces we want to inhabit and continue the dialogue and grand project that John Gillespie started in 1957. I ask that you continue to enjoy the evening. Thank you.
And now we will have a few words from Gary Turton, who is the chair of the Board of Architecture of Trinidad and Tobago. They have also partnered with us on this event, so they are silver partners. Thank you to the board.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Renata. I just have a few words. I was only asked to speak yesterday or day before. It is my honor, of course, to be able to speak at this exhibition. You know, I always admired the work of John Gillespie and his practice. And it's a special event to be able to celebrate one's work while they're still alive. And as an architect, you really tire, you know, quietly all throughout your career, you know, not necessarily looking for recognition, but certainly it's an honor to be recognized by your peers and by others in your country. And I wish he was here to be part of the event, you know. I just would like to say on behalf of the Board of Architecture that, you know, we're pleased to be able to contribute to such an exhibition. It's very rare that we have such an opportunity, and, you know, it's our pleasure to be able to contribute. So with that, I'll pass the show back to Renata, and thank you all.
Thank you, Gary. So we will now have a few words from Omar Mohamed, who's representing the Sherwin Williams Company. They are one of our two gold sponsors, partners. Omar.
Good evening, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Renato. It's an extreme pleasure for us to be here, and we're also very happy to be a part of this event. When Renato approached me about this tribute to John Gillespie, there was no hesitation. I don't know, I mean, you all are familiar with us. We have been in the country in the form that we are currently in since 2007. So you have been exposed to us to certain degrees. Sherwin Williams is actually over 150 years old. And wherever we are, we forge relationships with the architectural and design community. And you may think that that's logic or logical because, you know, it's an avenue for us to get our products out there. Well, yes, it is, but there's also a greater goal for us. The company believes that architects and the design community are just as important, or even equally important, as I must say, as doctors, lawyers, the legislators. You all have the ability to affect our lives. You all have the ability to form our moods, to influence our attitudes towards our country, towards our region. And I am truly delighted to be here this evening to support the TTIA and the architects in the audience and the design community as well. I'm a little disheartened in that I would have hoped to have seen more suppliers like us here honoring John Gillespie and his work. But the few of us that are here want you to know that we're here to support the architectural community and design community in Trinidad and in the region. As you know, the global push is towards sustainability and decreasing the carbon footprint. And you know, I have to ask a question of the audience tonight. When you specify for your projects, whether it be residential or commercial, hospitality, or any project that you're working on, what products are you specifying? Are you pushing us towards that goal of sustainability and lowering the carbon footprint? I would encourage you to engage companies that are going in that direction, not just Sherwin-Williams. And if you are handling a project and you want to speak about generic systems, I am available. We don't have to talk brands, labels, because as you can imagine, Sherwin-Williams is a truly global company. We are at the forefront of that initiative. Every year we develop new products. And unfortunately, the Caribbean as a region is a bit behind in that push. And I implore you to get active as an institute, as a group of professionals. Get active and push the region to what it should be and where we can be. I lived out of Trinidad for 20 years in various countries, not Europe, unfortunately. And I chose to come back home. I chose to come back home because I believe in Trinidad and Tobago. I believe in the people that are here. We have our problems, but as I said, I stand in front of a group of people who have the power to make a change in a very positive way. And I just want to say that once again, that we are beside ourselves to support this initiative and support the architects in this region, in Trinidad. Before I go, you know, just one last point. Are you still looking at products that are carbon-based, or are you looking towards hybrids and water-based solutions that will give us sustainability and actually improve the end result or the space for the end user? I just want to say again, we're very proud of being associated with the TTIA, and we are resolute in our stance to support the architectural community in Trinidad and Tobago and the region as well. And we are beside ourselves, as I said, to be supporting and honoring John Gillespie and his work. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, Omar. I am looking for Nick True. And I can't see everyone's faces from Precast Concrete Services Limited. Nick, are you here? No? Okay. So we will move on to Mr. Gillespie. He has pre-recorded his opening remarks for tonight. So there's a video that we're going to show. So we can go ahead and bring that up.
Good evening, everyone. Mr. President, I wish to thank you and your executive team for giving our practice the opportunity to present our work in the public forum for the first time. Truly a bonus after many years of relative anonymity. Emergence from the shadows. Though I hasten to add that this remark has nothing to do with the exhibition's title, Out of the Shadow, which of course refers to the country's release from a long and stultifying period of colonialism and the new opportunity we have been given to evolve an architecture of our own making. Neither a pseudo-American version nor a Chinese version, but one that reflects our own particular condition. As architecture is concept and development, and so a team game, I would like to take this opportunity to recognize the work of a number of architects who made their design contributions to the practice. Prominent among whom were Colvin Chen, longtime partner, Robert Douglas, who sadly died recently in Botswana, Nalini K. Siobhan, now retired and back home in Bangalore, Dion Wilson, Stephen Jameson, Sharon Bidesi, and Lloyd D'Souza, our interior design partner. At this point, I could bore you by expounding upon a few issues of concern. For example, design build as a methodology for local design and construction. A North American format, the opposition of which in any small Caribbean island is, in my opinion, both cumbersome and unnecessary, and has been so damaging to the development of architecture in Trinidad and Tobago. But I think perhaps this is not the forum for that discussion, and so I refrain from further comment. Broadly speaking, the work of the practice may be seen as synonymous with the first 50 years of an independent Trinidad and Tobago. Clearly a critical period for the country and for architecture by the need to develop the roots of a regional expression inevitably built upon a skeleton of a philosophy of Western machine age modernism. It is in that context that this exhibition has been assembled under the direction of architect Renata Allam as its curator, assisted by Gabriel Woodham, who is responsible for the graphics of its presentation. Thank you to them both and to the government for making Killarney available. As far as the exhibition is concerned, hopefully the work speaks for itself. Only with the cautionary reminder that architecture as a practical art may only be fully appreciated as a living experience in the moment of passage. The photographic image is no substitute, as by freezing the moment, it tends to emphasize the spectacular, which is not the primary concern of what architecture is about. Now well launched into a cyber age, I would like to conclude my remarks by leaving you to ponder over a quotation by Michael Heim, which is taken from a work entitled The Erotic Ontology of Cyberspace, edited by the ecologist Michael Benedict. As we suit up for the exciting future in cyberspace, we must not lose touch with the Zionites, the body of people who remain rooted in the energies of the earth. They will nudge us out of our heady reverie in this new layer of reality. They will remind us of the living genesis of cyberspace, of the heartbeat behind the laboratory, of the love that still sprouts amid the broken slag and the rusty shells of oil refineries under the poisoned silver sky. On a lighter note, I hope you enjoy the exhibition, find it stimulating. Beware of the superficial, the eye-catching moment. Architecture lives rather in the light and shadow of daily life. Thank you.
Yes, so 6:30, okay, we're on time. So I know it's a Monday evening, today is World Architecture Day, that's why we had it on this day. So I would like everyone to have enough time to see a bit of the exhibition tonight. So I know everyone will be coming back because it's gonna be open for 6 weeks. So the exhibition is set out where the ground floor has all of the completed projects and then the order that they were completed. So you'll move through and see all the different panels. It's in a linear order. And then on the first floor, we have the unbuilt projects. So there's a performing arts center for local art forms and a steel pan theater in one room. And then in the second room, there is a conceptual analysis of what Port of Spain could be. In that room as well, there's a monitor, and there's some educational videos on city development in other places, as well as Mr. Gillespie has recorded two other statements. And then there's an interview between Dion Wilson, who's also a registered architect and a former director at Gillespie and Partners. And he is being interviewed by Nico Brewster, who's one of the TTIA student members. So it's a lot to take in tonight. We also have workshops every Saturday, starting from this Saturday. And we encourage everyone to tell their friends to sign up for workshops. And we want as many schools to come during the week so teachers can sign up directly with the castle. All of this information is on the website. So with that being said, the exhibition is now open. And so whoever would like to go in can. Otherwise, we can stay and continue to enjoy the gardens. We have a slideshow that was prepared by Sam Bain of the staff over the years. Thank you. Thank you again.
Family is everything. Family is priceless. Don't miss the moments, especially the final ones. Pure PLAYRZ Production. Family is everything. Family is priceless. Don't miss the moments, especially the final ones. Pure PLAYRZ Production allows you to be there with our live stream service. It's totally customizable. Song lyrics and readings can be added live. Our website calculates your cost in real time. Visit pureplayersproduction.company.site or pureplaypro.com and be there.
Now